When I was young, I was obsessed with ninjas. A perfect camouflage in traditional Japan. But can you imagine how they would look like in the modern world? Their idea of camouflage would be completely redundant in an urbanizing world, and they must change their disguise to fit in with the times. And not only did humans change to fit with the industrial world, but animals too. And let me bring you to our prime example here, Biston betularia, or the peppered moth. This video will explore the study of Henry Bernard Davis Kettlewell and its study titled Selection Experiments on Industrial Melanism in Lepidoptera. But first, a little background on these moths. These moths have three main phenotypes, which are classified into subspecies: typical, white-bodied, carbonaria, black-bodied, and the far less common insularia, the intermediate phenotype. This is a simple trait, with only one locus being responsible for the phenotype between typical and carbonaria, and the allele for carbonaria being dominant. And before the Industrial Revolution, about 1-2% of the moths were carbonaria, and the typical remained the most common. But scientists noticed carbonaria was growing in areas near factories such as in Birmingham, a shift now defined as industrial melanism. But nobody knew why this was happening. Lepidopterist J.W. Tutt theorized that the coal from the factories covered the trees and made typical's camouflage against the light birch redundant to predation by birds, predicting that these once ninjas of the natural world are selected against in an industrial environment. Thus, the carbonaria phenotype began to be more prominent, but he had no way of proving this. And this is where Kettlewell comes in the 50s. He found an empirical method of tracking the natural selection of these moths, unlike the common observe and report method of scientists during that period. And so Kettlewell did three experiments. The first was that he gave each moth a score of conspicuousness, depending on how far away participants could spot the moth in different backgrounds. Not surprisingly, typical hid well on birch trees, carbonaria hid well on oak trees, and insularia was in between on both. He wanted to see if these scores were reflected in predatory birds, so he placed these moths on dark and white trees in an aviary and released these birds. Turns out, the birds tended to eat the moths in order from his ranking from most conspicuous to least conspicuous. And the most famous of all, his release and recapture technique. He released the moths of different phenotypes into the woods of industrial Birmingham, tagging them with a dye. After intervals of time, he recollected them using pheromones and a moth light. He counted what percentage of moths remained, and 20% of carbonaria, 13% of typical, and 17% of insularia were recaptured. This gave an indicator of their relative fitness within Birmingham. And from these experiments, Kettlewell made the following conclusions. Phenotypes had different levels of camouflage to the human eye, which was also reflected in the birds hunting them. Carbonaria was more fit in industrial areas, typical in unpolluted areas, and insularia was intermediate in both. And the birds acted as the selective agents. After this incredible work, he continued to publish another paper. This time he also tested the unpolluted Dorset woods and confirmed that the white form survived more often in unpolluted areas.
This was huge. Kettlewell managed to demonstrate natural selection in action and how environmental pressures can vary. Now, this study is extremely important as it links to population genetics, specifically a further understanding of natural selection. It became a lead textbook example, as natural selection has three traits:
variation, inheritance of traits, fitness differences. We have a clear example of all of these elements. We know there are subspecies, and this is controlled by a simple Mendelian genetics. This is where Kettlewell comes in, to identify fitness differences. His work shows how selective pressures affect the probability of a moth to survive and shows how fitness would vary in different environments. In a clean environment, it shows that the selective pressure, which scientists denote as S, would be more intensive on carbonaria moths, and its fitness, denoted as W, would decline, meaning that the probability of it to have further offspring would decrease. On average, this means its population would decline, and the frequency of the dominant allele would decrease. But in an industrial environment, the selective pressure would be less intensive, allowing its population to grow and the frequency of the dominant allele to increase as well. This would be the opposite for its white-bodied equivalent, whereas insularia is not highly fit nor highly selected against in either environment, allowing it to remain relatively stable among both populations. This demonstrates directional selection, a shift in traits in a population towards one extreme, in this case, white to black in industrial England.
Kettlewell showed the process of natural selection with empirical evidence, and it would become a cornerstone for understanding population genetics. And it's all thanks to this little creature.